Skip, I guess I could live with it because it's going to be a dead ball. They've already stopped the play, so you're not stopping play.
Yeah.
It's different than the NFL rule that now you can challenge what you think should have been a call or all that other foolishness. I just like, you know, I like the change of possession. If the ball goes out of bounds or something of that nature, okay, I don't have a problem with it. But I guess I can live with it since the clock will already be stopped, since the foul will have been called. And you're questioning whether there was a foul committed or not. It's not like, well, I think there should have been a call, so I'm going to challenge this. Mm-hmm. So I can live with that because the play would have already been stopped. Mm-hmm. And so you're saying, that's not a foul. So let's go back and take a look at it.
It's a foul called on your player.
Your player, correct, okay. Yes. So I can live with it.
So you can actually live with getting it right. Why wouldn't you embrace getting it right? You're grudgingly, with teeth clenched, saying, I can,
but Skip,
I'll be okay with that. What if it's right?
But here's the thing, Skip. There's a human element to calling games. I don't care. Unless you challenge every play, unless you review every play, you're not going to get every play right. And I think that's what these leagues are trying to do. You're not going to get every play right. There's a human element to calling ball games. Mm. The quarterbacks, the defensive back, the coaches, they're all human.
Mm. I despise the human element because it is fixable with today's technology.
No, it's not, Skip.
Yes, it is.
So you want to fix every play?
I want to fix as many as there is time for. And if you get this down to a science, and they said they're going to have another official sitting courtside to expedite this process.
Right.
So he'll just be sitting on press row, and he will look quickly at the video to help push the referees in the right direction.
Right.
Okay? And maybe he'll be a little more impartial, where it's always hard on the referees to look bad, you know,
right,
to make themselves like, okay, you got us,
right,
you know, because it's hard for whoever the head referees to say, yeah, that guy, he missed that, or the woman missed the ball, whoever it was, you know, like that's wrong.
Right.
But if you have impartial at courtside, and obviously they're talking back to the home office, then maybe you can get it righter faster and make the game go faster. Because sometimes they go look at it 15 times when you're sitting in your living room saying, that's so obviously wrong.
Skip, they get one challenge.
Okay.
So in other words, you're saying the officials get all of them right except like one time a game.
Okay, but obviously you're going to have to save your challenge for the last 2 minutes of a close game.
Well, you can't because it'll automatically be.
Okay, but not foul calls in the last 2 minutes.
Right.
Right?
You need a timeout.
Okay, you need to save a timeout and a challenge.
Right.
Well, I wish they got at least, because I'm so pro replay, I wish they had a challenge per half where at least you could say, If you got a really bad call in the first 5 minutes of the game.
Or treat it like NFL, get two, and if you get it right, you get a third.
Okay, they're saying it doesn't matter whether you get it right or not. You know, you're not going to get another one. It's over and out.
Well, dang, what's my incentive?
Okay, and what still grates on my nerves is this will not fix the robbery of the century that happened in your hometown of New Orleans, not your home, where you live, obviously, which was a non-call in the Saints-Rams. You should be scarred. A lot of people are scarred.
Skip!
It kept that team from going to the Super Bowl and maybe winning the Super Bowl.
Win.
Well, whatever.
Skip,
they were going to win that game.
Skip, there is a human element to it. I mean, you make it seem like these egregious calls. And if this was like the catch rule that was coming up weekly, I could, you know what, Skip, maybe I can come to your side. But this was an isolated incident.
Mm.
And we're going to turn the whole cart upside down over one bad apple?
Yeah. Well, at least they're trying to fix it while the Hall of Famer across from me keeps saying, maybe, you know, I guess I can live with that.
Yeah, I guess I can live with it.
Okay.
They already stopped the clock, so.
Well, trial basis, 1 year. We'll see if it's days or what tweaks they make to it. Up next, is Kawhi making a short-term stay with the Clippers?
What?
That's odd,
really?
Right? We'll discuss that when we come back.